Hello everyone, FunshineX here, and I am on the Utopia³ server. This is the server I was invited to help some vanilla guys learn Feed the Beast. And it's starting to take shape. We've actually got some buildings here at spawn that some nice builder, some people that know how to build have been doing. Much nicer than I can do. Here's the hive. It's starting to get a little bit bigger. A lot of the cells are still pretty empty, and I don't have any bees in there at all, so I still have quite a lot to do. This is going to be a world tour again, just like last episode, so I'm going to start here at spawn. And you can see I've got a jetpack, so we can get around. This building is still just a work in progress. It's mostly just a shell. Same with that one. I think there is a stone generator in there. I really like the little central park area here. And then over there is a scrap box machine, so it just recycles cobble. Yeah, might as well go see it. Forget who made it. I think Mondef made it. It says on the sign here, so we'll know soon. This is Scrapatron 2500 by Mondef. Okay, so it's kind of a subscriber special he built. He's got generators being powered by anything that comes out of the scrap that you can. Let's see, what's this thing? Yeah, I don't know. Anyway. So cobble's coming out from these igneous extruders, being recycled, scrap box is coming over here, being teleported over to there, and you can see it's completely full, but he's got a little void pipe now that if it's full it'll go in there. So yeah, you just put a button and some presents come out. Pretty cool. I get mostly scrap. Sometimes you get wooden material and I just go throw them in here because I don't need them. Anyway, that's that room. Let's go check out my base. The original spawn building here, hut, bunker, whatever, is still pretty much the same. Nothing's really changed there. I switched the blaze farm here to use conveyor belts from Mine Factory Reloaded. Because blazes are hurt by water, occasionally a blaze would die to water and then they just don't drop experience or their blaze rod. So this way ensure that every single blaze blaze that spawns will die to the turtles. And you can see each of these turtles has grabbed quite a few blaze rods. Any that sneak by are sucked into this transposer, which goes to an ender chest to my base. I think I showed that before. If not, that's what it does. So I steal all the blaze rods. Everybody else can have the experience, or they go into one of those turtles and just take out some blaze rods. So here's the hive. Up that way is empty. You'll notice I got rid of all my chests because I'm using Applied Energistics now. If you want to see how to set this up, go watch my other series on the Feed the Beast Ultimate Artisan server. Really, it's very minimum on the server that I've done right now. Really just an interface storage drive here with just 1k. I've got 5k total. I think total I'm using 20 per tick, so not very big system. I can turn this whole section off, so if I don't need to access the storage drives or whatever, I can just turn it off, especially like when I'm offline. I usually turn it off, and then you can see it only does 14, so saves me a little bit, not a ton. And then I can turn the entire system off by turning the MFE off that powers it. Down here, this is my main input chest, so if I go quarrying or do turtles or mining anything, I just put it into this chest and it'll get sucked into my system. Back here, I've got an interface that if you give it a empty, it crafts full water buckets basically. So it puts an empty water bucket in the deployer and then pulls out full water buckets with the import bus. This guy's working off blaze rods and charcoal to power my system. So that's really the entire power for my AE system when the blaze rods come in or when a charcoal comes in from upstairs, which I'll show you. This system crafts me bog earth. So I have a I can go into the wall here. Interface here, it's got the recipe for bog earth. and it will just put it in the fabricator and craft it up. Let me grab the extra sand here. And then I've told it to pull out all bog earth and all empty buckets back into the system. So that way I've got auto crafting, but I don't have to build that entire gigantic box that you've seen me build in Applied Energistics. Alright, so yep, just come in here. You could say I need some bog earth. Craft me up some bog earth. Give me 10. Begin. It'll go get some full water buckets using the first system and then go get some bog earth. Here, craft some bog earth. There you go. Okay, what else we got? Upstairs, I've got windmill that's expired or broken, whatever. It's going into this bat box, which has also got some solar power up there. This is another empty room here. A few miscraft items, not much. These all come down into this bot box, which is also empty because it's nighttime and my windmill's not running. And then here's my entire machine room. I think it's been expanded quite a bit since I last show you guys a video. All the IC2 stuff, not very big deal. Not using the steam engines at the moment, but now that I've got extra charcoal, I probably might set these guys up back up to run, or I'll just go in for the steam boiler, who knows. I'm using a item liquid tesseract here to get lava. Cento's got a good mine in the nether to get all this lava. We plan on having a custom miscraft age that's just a water ocean biome that's lava, and everybody gets their lava from one place. That way we don't have to have tons of chunks loaded for getting lava. And I'm just powered by these three engines, and any red power will go into here. Or blue-tricity, sorry, will go into there. I think should be full. Yep. And then I've just got the standard bank of machines and some railcraft and some forestry stuff. Cart assembler and soul forge. And that's about it there. So let's go outside where the cool stuff's happening right now. Oh, and it's night. I might run into some stuff. Here I've got peat farm. Standard peat farm here. And then all the way around it, a Steve Cart's tree farm. This guy has a regular coal engine that's running on charcoal and the woodcutter, and then just one set of side chests. You can see he's just collecting the apples and the saplings and the trees. Those are going to come around when he's done and be deposited in here in the cargo manager. And I'm just using one color. He's going to take everything out of his inventory or out of his storage slots and put it here. If he has room for any saplings, he'll go ahead and put them back into his sapling area. And if he's got room in his engine, he'll take the charcoal out. Well, where's the charcoal coming from? Let's go find out. Oop, got some ash on the ground. Looks like I have a bug here. Here's my peat farm. Oh yeah, I need to put another golden pipe back there to get the ash. Any peat that comes out of the peat engines will come through here. Should fill up this peat fired engine, and then the extras will go into the ender chest, into my storage system. Alright, here's the magic. Cargo manager, it's got all this stuff, right? Filter's gonna pull out, wrong filter. Stacks of 8 wood at a time, apples or saplings, whatever's in there. They're gonna come down here, and let me through. We'll go into the top slot here of these furnaces. Hopefully, I might use a sorting machine. Yep, for that reason exactly. My train doesn't cut enough wood, so other things come through. So I'm gonna have to put a sorting machine in there and color this pipe so that only wood goes through here. For now, let me just take some of this wood. There we go. That's being cooked up in the furnace, and any charcoal will come out through these. I could get gates here, but I just don't have buildcraft assembly table yet. And they will all be fed into this relay. The relay then throws the charcoal. If there's any room in the bottom of the furnaces, they'll go in there. And then any extra will come up here, and it's either going to go through this filter or to this relay because they're the same distance apart. So it's kind of random. It'll go one there, pretty much 50 for 50, 50. And then, so that extra charcoal will come back in here. Looks like I am building up too much charcoal, so eventually this whole thing will be full of charcoal, which is not good. So I'll have to solve that problem. I might just manually grab out a bunch of stacks, but if I left this on the server running and I didn't show up for like a week, then I could have problems. No, it wouldn't be too big. Things wouldn't be on the ground, it's just everything would stop processing. So that's how I'm getting my charcoal and my saplings. Automatically, no input required from me. I just leave this guy running. He is chunk loaded. I've chunk loaded like that chunk, and this chunk. I think I have like a 3x3 area. That's my base. Let's go over here. See what other bases we can find. I know there's one in here. We don't have a Nexus yet, which would be nice to get. But let's go see the Warlord's base, see what they've done. This thing's crazy. Right here. That's a cool little painting. That must be from the texture pack I have. Founders, Henge, and Nether. What do you got? Pages? Oh, fast weather page and the charged page. So they've got two Mistcraft villagers here, which is pretty cool. Oh, lots of zombie heads. I don't know what all these rooms are. I haven't been here in a while. That's cool. Must have killed each other to get that one. Anything cool in here? I'm looking for like cool crafting systems or automated systems. Oh, cool, they got one of the rainbow trees from Extra Biomes. Those are pretty rare to see. They've made some stained glass. Whoa, I don't know where this is gonna send me. This could be bad. Okay, we didn't take too much damage. What are these guys trading? Emeralds for water shard, huh? And chicken nuggets for emeralds. There's their store. These are new buildings. Let's go see what's in here. Zycraft blocks. Whoa, they've got a ton of Zycraft blocks. Holy crap. That's pretty cool. So all these barrels are being fed by one router from here, I believe. So if you just put items in there, it'll route them into a chest that they fit in, which is pretty cool. I like that system. Looks like some test racks here. Private ones, so I can't see what they're doing. Twilight Forest portal. What's going on here? This must be a... goodness. Some kind of mob farm. So they're dropping them here. They're using a water elevator up and then dropping them to kill. So they're almost dead and then kill them with the turtles, I guess. Which are not running. They're not running. Okay. How do you turn them on? Where's your switch? So they're farming zombies and skeletons. Those must not be tier 5, because that was just a... Oh, he's got some wither. A wither must spawn in another location. I guess I don't need to sword them, I can just punch them. And I'm going to grab a few wither skeleton heads while I'm here. Where are you going? Are you hiding? Come back. That zombie's stuck. Cool. Ah, that must be with another wither skeletons are spawning. And then it looks like they've got some I like the trees. Those are cool trees. Some old forestry farms set up here. I wonder if they're going to do the new ones or not. Alright, let's get out of here. See if we can go see another base. What do we got? Nether fortress? I don't want to go to the nether. Or the fortress, anyway. Let's go check out Cento and Beepat's room. Their castle, basically. This is a really cool build. I really like it. These guys, you know, they work on aesthetics, you know, which is cool. It's what I like to do. I always don't get it right. You know, I try, but it doesn't always happen. But these guys, for the most part, figured out the aesthetics along with the Feed the Beast mods, so it's pretty cool. I got a big lava window there. Sonatron. Need some music. So they've got crystals here. So we must have a lot of Mistcraft exploration going. Your table. Nice stuff. How do we get out of here? Outside. Get a nice view of it here. Whoa, it's expanded quite a bit. It's the entryway. Come to this bridge. Big towers. Wow. Whoa. I would be nervous that I'm just make sure my jetpack has fuel. I would be nervous that my building would burn down if that happened. I guess they've made sure they're either far enough away or they're using red power blocks that don't burn. I don't know where that's going. Oh, this is a lightning rod. So they've got it up to height maximum, maybe? Wow. Oh, I can't get... My jetpack doesn't work that high. So the lightning rod takes power into this guy. Oops. That must be an extreme voltage converter. And then to a medium. Into MFSUs. Extreme into ultra. Whatever. Or extreme into high. There we go. Cool, and then they're expanding around this. I wonder how much they get from the lightning rods. I mean, it looks like their MFSUs are full. Eh, not quite. Yeah. But, I mean, if you do get a good storm, that would give you some free energy. I'm going to put one of these in on the other server. But it looks like I need to craft one of those, and... Who knows what that takes with Gregtech. Gregtech. Oh, I haven't been down this way before. Probably just another way down, yep. So what's going on here? Generators? Yeah, just lava generators, IC2 lava. Chemical reactor? Canning machine? Macerator. So they've got some Gregtech and some IC2 stuff here. Cool. Isn't there a basement? Yeah. I love their armor stands. This is a industrial grinder. Cool. I haven't built one of those yet. This will be the blast furnace. They're doing all purple, so they're getting 2200 heat. That's pretty cool. The Naga blocks, that's pretty cool. Really like that. What's this guy doing? Matter fabricator. Alright. All that you matter. And scrap. Wow. I gotta get into one of these. Implosion compressor? I keep putting... Look at that crazy setup you gotta do. That's cool. They're definitely working on Greg Tech. They've got just one laser here. They could definitely use some more lasers. Let's see. That's their Miscraft Age room. And I think we've visited everything now. So how do we get back? Anyone see a Miscraft book back to Nemsun's base? Founder's Henge. Lewis's hut. Let's go check out Lewis's hut in the Twilight Forest. I need some food, though. Ah! There we go. Here we go. Twilight Forest time. What do you got, Lewis? Not a lot. Oh, there we go. Now? Maybe he stopped building in the Nether, or the Twilight Forest area, and went to the main world. Three overworlds. Name your books! This could be bad. Alright, that's back here. Let's try this one. There, this is a new place. Okay, I've been here once, but this has changed quite a bit. There's storage. I like the blocks. What's this holding? Water. And what's through here? Whoa. Cool, how do I get down there? He's got AE crafting going on. I don't see stairs to get down. Oh, maybe there. Here we go. Blast furnace, bunch of tanks. What are you holding? Nothing. Lava. Fermenters, so he's missing some saplings or something. That's why that tank's empty. That's next on my list, is to ferment my saplings and get some biofuel. Or biomass. Alright, I don't know how to get into his AE system. Maybe that's on purpose. Yeah, just for looks. I don't see a door in there. Oh, there is a door in there. Through that wall. There must be a secret entrance. No, I don't know how to get there. So he's got a Peat system. Looks like it's been turned off for a while. Okay, well, there's one last place to go, and this is Founder's Henge book. I have no idea what this is. Hey, it's the Nexus. Okay, so someone built this. And didn't tell me about it. Spawn. Empty. The end. Hey, I've got a base. Cool. The Great Misty Hall, Linking Center. Warlord set up a kill. So I need to get a book. Is there any books here? Maybe? Ah, darn it. I'll have to bring a book back here and link to this. We can go home, though. Right through here. Look, we're home. Yay, Creeper took out my sign, by the way. I think that's going to do, guys, for this episode of Feed the Beast Utopia Cubed Server World Tour. I will be back when I've got some more updates. I know I want to get some more processing going of my liquid so I have more fuel, and then as soon as we get that done, we will be going for bees. start with just some normal breeding, and then we'll get into extra bees and all that kind of stuff. Until then, this has been FunshineX. I'll see you next time. Bye.